eSportBets.com – уникальное место для настоящего геймера. Только здесь возможны ставки на киберспортивные события. Ты знаешь толк в самых популярных играх и готов рисковать? Смотри регулярные трансляции и зарабатывай реальные деньги. eSportBets.com – живой азарт и холодный расчет.
All right, welcome back everyone. This is now finally getting on the way. Epsilon versus NaVi. Best of one game here, and it's going to be on Dust 2. Took a little bit of time to get started because I think Epsilon were a little bit slow to get home. They were just, or at least get on the server. And NaVi, well, they're actually the ones missing now, so I really don't know what the explanation is. But either way, we had a bit of a delay, and I'm sorry about that. But now we are getting it on the road here. Semler and Vendetta, of course, you're here too. It's a room on fire, so it couldn't be any different. I mean, this game is going to be a pretty sick one, I think.
Should be a pretty good game, not going to lie. I'm actually really excited to see how FXO holds up, because he had a really hot start to his career in Epsilon. So, interested to see if he's able to keep that up.
Yeah, I think we've only seen... I only count one game so far where I've seen FXO not step up to the plate. And that was the same game as when... Shoxi didn't either. One day played against Fnatic on Mirage. And apart from that, he's been playing really well. So, I mean, we've been watching how many games with them now? 5, 6, 7 or something like that? So, that's pretty good.
Yeah, absolutely. So, expecting big things from FXO and obviously Shoxi as well.
Now, there is something going on here, though, which is... I mean, just talking about the bets for a second, because obviously, you know, skins are very important and all that stuff. Yesterday, NaVi took a whole bunch of losses, or near losses at least, and just played not very well. And they seemed like basically not like NaVi at all. And I have a theory that maybe... I mean, I think NaVi is one of those teams that actually sometimes they play worse against, you know, opponents that they aren't maybe used to playing against. Or just, like, they play worse against worse opponents and better against better opponents. That makes sense?
They play to the level of their opponents.
Yeah, that's what I wanted to try and express, exactly.
Yeah, I can agree with that, because we did see them play really well versus VP.
Yeah.
And then they went on to lose to Reason and... or Gunu IN in a really weird game. I think we can easily solidify that as one of the weirdest games we've seen in a while.
Yeah. Do you think it's a mentality thing when it comes to NaVi? That it's just, it really is just that, like, they can't seem to get in the proper mindset if they don't have respect for the team that they're facing?
I really don't know.
I don't know. I hope that's not the case. That shouldn't be an issue for such seasoned players as these guys are. So no. That might have been something when... It might have been a thing when you've recently gotten to the top. So, let's say, for instance... So that would be something I could have expected from Fnatic right after their win at DreamHack. Something like that. But not a team like NaVi with these players in it.
No, I really hope not either. That definitely is not a good sign if that's what it comes... I don't know what it comes down to then. I mean, something definitely just was very screwed up yesterday. We'll have to see if it's different for today. If you're just joining the channel, then of course a big welcome. Remember to click the links at the bottom of the stream where you have our Facebook raffle, also our sponsor video, which Semler and I are doing a little bit of acting, and it's good fun, so click it and check it out. It's definitely going to make you laugh, if nothing else. And this is obviously Room on Fire. We have Epsilon versus NaVi, best of one game in the SLTV Starseries Season 10. So welcome to the show, and a big thanks to everyone who subscribed. And a bit of an update as well. Yesterday, actually, someone donated a Karambit Urban Mask knife to the stream. That was Stony Maloney. So big thanks to you, Stony, if you're still watching. I think it's the biggest donation we've had so far, and we're going to be giving it away. Stony gave it to us with the explicit purpose of doing a subscriber giveaway. So we're going to be doing that tomorrow, guys. Just a bit of a reminder so nobody forgets to tune in. Obviously, tomorrow we have our Case King of the Hill tournament, so you don't want to miss that anyway. We have LDLC, NIP, and then NaVi is the defending champion, so it's going to be a really sick day tomorrow. But that's just it. All right. What's up? What do you think? Who's going to win this best of one?
Epsilon.
All right, Epsilon. Yes.
Yeah, you just told me to name something. I'm not going to justify it.
No, it's
I'm
all
just
right.
going to say Epsilon.
Semler? Are you on the Epsilon boat as well?
I think this is a team that NaVi might wake up for. So I'm actually gonna go with NaVi this time, guys. I think Guardian can go toe to toe with FXio, and it's gonna be the Shoxi factor that makes it for Epsilon if he wakes up on Dust 2, which is definitely one of his strongest maps, flat out.
We're gonna find out. Epsilon are gonna be starting on the terrorist side, and it will be NaVi on the CT side. And see, Edward has gone back to one of his old names as well. And actually, this is something that some pro players do. They switch names when things aren't going so well for them, which is a really weird idea, but I guess if it makes you feel better, you can do it.
Dude, this is just one of those things where it's like changing your, you know, you got your magical underwear, right?
Exactly.
Like your game day underwear. And every time you've won, you've been wearing this pair of underwear, so you're never going to change this pair of underwear when it comes to an official match. You're always going to have that pair of lucky underwear. It's just one of those things.
Your Mormon fireproof underwear, that's what you need at this point, just to avoid the Molotovs. It's a really good start for Epsilon here, and Guardian did get a good headshot early on, but now Shox is the only one dead. SF is really close to it. FXio is going to peek out and does shoot a little bit through the box here as well. Does some minimal amount of damage to Seize, but the problem here is the time. Seize now in a 1-on-4, and this is a strong start for the Frenchies once again here. And, I mean, being on the more favorite side, this is, I think, everything they could want.
Yeah, really nice start. And GMX pretty much opening up that entire 80 site with those two picks he had. So that made the job easy for the French team to really... There wasn't really any contest that felt like that, so that was just Epsilon's round through and through.
Actually, FXio hit that last shot on Seuss. That was pretty cool. With the scout jumping over. But I don't know. That was... Yeah, that just seemed like once Guardian went down, that was almost the round. In the middle here, we got seized very close. Gonna peek in against two people, and actually it will be Seuss to pick up the return, and Edward with the kill on Shoxi. So things now looking maybe a little bit tricky.
That was a really shoddy setup from Epsilon. Not having anyone at all peeking towards that B area, and Edward punishes them for it.
Seuss and Seized are very low here, and actually Starix trying to come up from behind is going to get caught. So very, very important detail from DMX there. If he lets Starix walk up behind them, they probably lose the round right then and there.
That would have definitely ruined their day. Seuss is about to get caught through the smoke. He's not, in fact. Luckily, dodges the bullet with only 2 points of health left, but then SF has to do a 180 and ruin his day.
Guardian. Sorry, it's time for the one deke here. He's got it in hand. He's looking for it. The hand cannon, but... Oh no, I saw that coming in my mind. It looked like he was so determined.
Bomb has been planted. He wills the one shot?
Exactly.
It doesn't really work out for Epsilon there. And even though they got off to an awful start, they managed to salvage it. But you could see Shoxi was asking Edward, how the hell did you get to lower? And I think that's just it's evidence that Epsilon were not really on point as to where they were holding off, and now you can see them spreading out a bit more.
Yeah, like you can expect the two guys in upper, unless they decide to make a rush out of this. I mean, the bomb is close. They know this is going to be an eco round, but Edward is here with the CZ-75, which makes him very dangerous up close. The current position that he's holding, and he's got support from doors as well.
Oh, what a shot from Edward. That was such a dirty flick, and Seize can't find the last bullet here. If he had hit Kyushima once more, it would have been a 1-on-2. Now the bomb is going to go down, and Shoxi will be covering that window. Almost gets his face taken off. They've got to be really careful here. Epsilon are actually having a really tough time playing against NaVi, even when NaVi just have pistols. So that's a scary thought moving into the next couple of rounds here. Let's see if NaVi can win this round.
Yeah, while the push was happening in B, there was a slaughter over at A long, and this is just crazy that it's turned into a 2-on-2. Finally, a good peep there by Shoxi nets the kill on Seuss, and Kyushima will find Seized. But Kyushima, only with 3 HP left, 28 on Shoxi. NaVi came way too close to taking that anti-eco. And that was a third round anti-eco, or eco round as well. Like, that is not, like, helmet armor or anything at all. It's just the guns that they've got, the pistols.
Yeah, I think FXio actually botched a bit of the defense in mid right there. He got picked off without doing pretty much any damage at all to any of the NaVi players, and that kind of just led to... that. Well, it gave NaVi the opportunity to just roam freely.
And what can we make of it, though? Guardian up on short here. Shoxi's going to be peeking. Guardian only just getting into position a little bit late, and he hasn't got any body armor, so a few bullets, and he's down to 40. Going to get flashed as well, and he goes down immediately. Good return from Seuss. Tries once more, but he's got to be careful. FXio is up there, and this is the result when you try and peek him without an orb and without any kind of backup as well. Starix probably needs to fall back, but he's going to be maybe walking right into GMX here, Semler.
Yeah, that was a bit of a mistake on Zeus's part, but this is still FXio alive, looking towards Long. He's in Goose, he's still alive somehow!
What?
FXio making the difference, 3 kills for him, but he is immortal! That was still a mistake on Zeus's part, I think, though. I mean, it's tough to call, really. It's tough to call. He can't know that the AWP is there, but still, like, he peeked before the flash went off. If he peeks by the time when that flash goes off, he may get that kill for free, but he peeks just before the flash goes off, and that's all FXio needs to spot him and take the shot.
This time it's looking like a similar push to the B-bomb site that Epsilon did a couple of rounds ago, where they almost actually lost the round, but this time Edward isn't as fast with the flick. Seastar will pick off one and just keeps trying here with the Deagle. See if he can get one more shot in.
Flash is not really going to help too much, except taking a little bit of damage as he gets onto the site, but there's still everybody from Na'Vi right here outside the doors.
Yeah, what are the other Epsilon players doing? This is actually just a complete screw-up here. Shoxi has to get so many kills. If he goes down here, and he will, now they have a big advantage. I have no idea what Epsilon were doing that round.
Oh, that nade! Oh, that nade from FXio. That was big. But it's still a 2-on-2. FXio up close. He's got the CZ. GMX looking to put that Molly to use. Good positioning there. Behind the new box, CZ is going to have to move. But he still gets the headshot on GMX. This is way too close.
And FXio draws it. He actually saves that round. I think Na'Vi, they should have definitely had that round. I mean, come on. They had the bomb in there. And they were the one defending. And they even knew where they were coming from. But it just is not good enough here. That was actually, I think that, you know, that was just a devastating round from both teams. I have no idea how Epsilon managed to put themselves in that position, but once Na'Vi took the lead, they should have pretty been able to carry all the way through, I think.
Yeah, actually, we talk about FXio saving the round, which he did, but he also nearly gave it away, because he was the one responsible of watching mid that entire time, and there's no way he could be in a position where he does not spot that 3-man rotation from Na'Vi without saying anything. And Epsilon took a really long time to actually commit to that B-bomb site with the bomb. They had Kiyoshima in there, but the bomb was still just hanging back by exit. So that could have easily been avoided by Epsilon if FXio just gives the proper information to his teammates.
Oh wow, Shoxi just kills Guardian. He was scoped up. There's a really good flash on Guardian the first time around, but actually the Slovakian Nova had a chance to sort of zoom up again now. GMX is waiting down here for the right timing for Starix. Sue's looking for a kill in the middle, but the bomb is already down, and this is really tricky. C's coming up good. Kiyoshima will get a kill in return, and Starix takes down the guy flanking down on Long. So now it's FXio and Shoxi trying to see if they can hold on to it here. Shoxi's going to pick off one, and now it's a 2-on-2. It's not done yet. FXio trying to see if he can hold it behind here. Not going to get it. Shoxi goes down, and FX is going to miss the next shot, and that will be the round in favor of Na'Vi. So great retake coming up finally here from the CT side, and it's thanks to Seize and that triple kill.
Edward, not really sure about Edward pushing through the smoke the way he did there.
Speaking of pushing through smokes, I'm not really sure what GMX was doing at Long either.
This is kind of all over the place, guys. I'm not too sure what to think right now.
I think that could have easily been Epsilon's round if GMX just remains patient for a couple of seconds more, really. As soon as anyone from Epsilon on site gets confirmation, well, that the one guy from Na'Vi at Long is actually trying to fight them, that's your go to actually push out. But before then, just stay back and hold up.
Really aggressive round coming up, and SF charging in with the bomb first, which is a big mistake, and Starix is going to take down the next guy in line, and this is just basically a throwaway round, it feels like. Now it's actually somewhere back into a 2-on-2. Kiyoshima is going to go down, and FXio takes down Edward. What was this round? It looked like Na'Vi was just outright winning that.
This just looks like a bunch of individual play.
Yeah.
Like everybody going for frags, everybody just kind of peeking, re-peeking, going through smoke. Weird, just weird plays. FXio now going to sneak up on Edward. Manages to get the drop on him, but then Edward comes so close. FXio down to 6 HP.
This grenade can kill Edward. The one he wanted to throw can kill Edward if it's perfect. Now he's going to be walking up Edward down towards the elevator, and FXio is going to go down. Edward with a good road movement coming out there at the end. Seemed like actually Edward should have gone down to FXio when he came down from long. This was just, and I'm just going to forget about that round. That was so weird.
That was actually a nice play from Epsilon. Not really sure if they anticipated the quick rotation from Na'Vi, but it definitely caught them off guard with FXio peeking out his head into mid. And it was basically just a result of Na'Vi being so focused on that catwalk push that it gave the opportunity for Kiyoshima and FX to backstab pretty much everyone on Na'Vi from both long and mid.
Yeah, that mid door push really worked wonders. Starks gets overwhelmed at long. That's not really going to help, but there is support here from Zeus. He gets quickly caught as well. Guardian will find a sick headshot on Shoxi, though.
Sick 1D from Kirishima. Now close up, here's DMX. Guardian missing a lot of shots. He's dropping low. Now they have the one rifle here, and it's going to be put to use. There's the one shot. There's the next one. DMX is going to be alone. Wants to put the bomb down, and I think he's going to be successful as well. So this is a big round for Epsilon. Three kills and a bomb plant is going to give them a lot of money to work with in the upcoming round. And it's going to put Na'Vi at a pretty huge, a pretty huge risk here because they just don't have a lot of money.
Yeah, and I saw one thing there that I really didn't like. It didn't have anything to do with any of the teams, but the fact, well, you know how when you plant the bomb, you automatically crouch, right?
Yeah.
You also automatically stand up while finishing dropping the bomb. And that could have been a big issue for Epsilon right there, because Na'Vi definitely had the potential to pick him up as he gets up there, and there's nothing the Epsilon player can do about it. If it had been if it had been like the old way, he would have been able to remain crouched the entire time and actually have a safe plant. Instead, he kind of just stands up willy-nilly, and that's dangerous for Epsilon in that situation. But luckily for them, they do get the plant.
Moving into the ninth round here, and I mean, Na'Vi have definitely managed to recover the really early loss that they had. They lost five rounds in a row now. They're up to a three-round win streak coming out. Zeus in the middle almost takes down FXO. He could have been shot then. Now he's trying to fall back, and they can't really easily return on him because they don't know what's happening on the other side of mid. So they don't want to commit to it. They just try and peek in and get a kill, and it doesn't really work out.
What I'm really excited to see is Seized with the SCAR 20. And he's waiting, he's looking towards upper dark. This could turn into a total chicken shoot here.
It's a big investment, obviously, from Seized. I mean, just imagine how scary it is
if it works, but if it doesn't. They're giving up the B-site!
They're gonna smoke it off again, though. In the middle, Zeus versus GMX. Zeus trying to shoot through. GMX actually has a big opening here to do something. He's going to be walking right in, takes down. Zeus turns around. Edward goes down, and GMX is the hero so far. Doesn't have to re-peek against Starix, and I'm really glad he realized that, because that is not worth it. Just wait for it. The bomb is down, and Na'Vi are going to have to run away. GMX, two really good kills, and then I'm so glad to see him just restrain himself. Like that one moment where he realizes, wait, I don't have to do this. I don't have to put this into a 2-on-3. We're in a 2-on-4, and we'll keep it that way.
Yeah, whereas Na'Vi are just hunting for frags. It looks like matchmaking. That was just so weird that they would leave the B side open. Everybody focusing on B slope like that. Everybody looking towards mid. Seized, by the time he looks back into B site, there's three guys out of the smoke already. So it's just, I don't know. It seems really weird there. I mean, it just seems like everybody's hunting for frags on Na'Vi's side right now.
What do you think, Ben? Auto sniper, do you agree with that purchase?
Yeah, I mean, he made it work last night, so I don't have any problem with him buying the auto sniper. I would have much more. I would have preferred to see him actually get back up behind the boxes on plateau more than anything. I don't really like that window position for a sniper unless you're someone like Guardian is able to do like that millisecond peek and make it work. But yeah.
The rush on towards the B bomb site. They're gonna catch Edward in the corner, but only one of them jumps around. I think maybe the others were flashed. This is a big problem. Edward will go down, but Guardian is here with the orb. He misses the shot, and it's somehow into a 2-on-4. And Epsilon, these B pushes have worked out almost none of the time. They've almost lost three rounds to this already. Seized is gonna get a kill, and now this is really frustrating to watch from the Frenchman, because this is just a silly way to lose rounds.
Goodbye, FXO. He sneaks out. Guardian catches him.
They managed to win it back almost, and then they lost two rounds now to doing this. So basically almost three rounds that they've thrown away in that B bomb site by rushing when they're up against Eco. It doesn't actually make sense.
Especially
with the fact that Na'Vi have been rotating extremely fast so far this game, and that's something Epsilon has to recognize. So I'm really surprised that they're actually committing so hard to bomb sites versus Ecos, because Na'Vi have been running all over the place.
Oh, very good that Guardian was there to pick up that kill, because otherwise GMX would have just got away with murdering Starix over there. So just a quick trade, still going to favor Epsilon at this point, because now Na'Vi have to make up their minds about how they want to hold it. And if they put Guardian alone up here and Zeus down here, oh man, if one of them goes down, all of a sudden it's tricky. They both have to play really just perfectly at this point.
Nothing to do with the actual what's going on in the game right now, but FXO has 34,000 frags on his AWP. Wow. Just saying, that's like scream level right there.
It's a lot of matchmaking.
That's a lot of practice. That's insane. All right, back to the point, though. Na'Vi have a pretty good position here, although FXO manages to get the drop on Guardian at angle, and that's really not going to help the defense here for Na'Vi. Zeus is in pit, and he's playing it so well passively. Let's one sneak in. They don't realize where he's coming from until too late.
Yeah, but when FXO does realize, that's all it takes. But now the bomb has actually been dropped here in the crossover, so it's a 2-on-2. Shoxi and FXO versus Edward and Seized. The Shoxio combo, can we call it that? Maybe we can. FXO picks up a kill, even though he's actually scoped up the wrong way. Edward trying to go for a jumping shot here now. 1-on-1 versus Shoxi. See if Shoxi can actually pull this one home, or if Edward is going to pick up the triple. Shoxi going for a bit of a shot there, doing some damage to Edward. He's down to half HP, and Edward is all the way down on long. Does go down to 21 HP, and Shoxi keeps peeking here, which is a little bit dangerous. They're both so low on health, and Shoxi, now Edward's close, and I think he's hurt him already. Shoxi looks really nervous right now. He's going to take the peek just once here, and Edward's coming around the box. Edward is going to go down. Shoxi survives on 17 health. What a long one-on-one battle that was.
And I actually think Shoxi should have been able to pick up Edward a lot sooner in that engagement. I thought it would have had him at least at three separate occasions during
Agreed.
That battle.
At long, when he was backing off at long?
Yeah.
But then you think, okay, Shoxi's got it, but then Edward still
nails the headshot, yeah.
That's really, really sick from Edward. I think that rocked Shoxi back on his heels a little bit there.
I think that shot from Guardian rocked FXO. That was really cool. That was actually through the box that's up by the T-spawn, so that's really interesting. See, he's going to walk in, take down SF. That was FAMAS versus Galil, and it works out. Now in the corner, Edward was hiding, takes down Kiyoshima, and Epsilon are getting completely picked apart this round. And if they lose it, they're going to have to eco. This is Na'Vi about to jump up to 6 rounds. This is a very, very big turnaround in this game.
Yeah, this is, this is huge as far as just momentum is concerned, but then Na'Vi with 6 rounds on their CT side, they should be able to pick up 5. We're not going to count it out yet because it's still Shoxi and GMX. Shoxi capable of coming up big pretty much at will, so if Na'Vi gets 6 rounds on CT side, though, that's pretty much this half won for them.
Although, as far as I remember last time, they played a lot better Na'Vi on the CT side than they did on the Terra side. Is that correct, Ben, from yesterday?
Yeah, they did, yeah.
Their terrorist side actually wasn't looking very good yesterday. I don't know if it could have changed today. They made a lot of really weird mistakes, so maybe they've just made up for it and they're going to be looking a lot better. In the middle,
out of curiosity, why is that?
Hard to tell.
Yeah, that was actually really hard to tell. It just seemed like they have... No, actually, it's not. They kept going for the B-bomb site. They kept going for the exact same B-split push that just never worked. So
okay, then.
Well, we talked about that as well last night. They did the B-split quite often. They knew where Rack was holding versus Penta, and, they kind of did the rinse-repeat thing over and over. And I think that's a round that easily could have worked for them as long as they hit their shots. It's just the fact that they weren't really on point last night compared to their normal level.
Holy hell, this is actually maybe going to be almost a double eco, I think, from Epsilon. They need a bomb plant here. A bomb plant would save the rest of this half for Epsilon. If they don't, they're going to have no money at all. Starix here with a very good double pickoff and then tries to stay alive a little bit longer. Backup is coming quick as well. And the bomb is down, so it's going to be no bomb plant at all this round. And this is pretty big. Na'Vi can get a lot of rounds here in the first half of the way it is now.
Love how Zeus has no fear, like zero fear. Starix is alive in pit, but Zeus is just like, I'm gonna get this pistol frag.
What do you think about this, man? They could buy one AK armor and they buy it on Kiyoshima, and yeah, everyone else is gonna be buying Galil's.
Yeah, I think they kind of came to the same conclusion as you did, that, oh, Na'Vi can get quite a few rounds here if we don't buy up, so I think they're just willing to force it and hope for the best, because you don't, it's like I said, you don't want to let Na'Vi have too much freedom or gain too much too easily on the CT side.
And look at this smart play. Guardian going to take down Kiyoshima in the middle. It's Edward looking up. Shoxi will take him down, but actually on the B-bomb side, Guardian and Seized just need to hold strong here for just a moment and they're going to be alright. And Guardian will pick up one more player. Seized up in the window is going to go down, leaving Guardian alone inside. He's going to get a third player. Peaks for the fourth and doesn't get it, so it's a 2-on-2. But I think the advantage here is with Na'Vi. They have the health, they have the kits, they even have a Molotov and anything else. So this is going to be a really tricky hold, I think, for Epsilon.
It's not looking too likely here. Na'Vi should be able to pull this off, especially since Zeus is coming in through Upper Dark. FXO is holding it with the AWP, though. But there's the Molly. He's going to burn to death. Starix, perfect nade onto FXO. and this should be the end here. SF gets the drop on Zeus! What? Then SF clutches it! Two kills, catches Starks through the doors, and Zeus out in the middle of nowhere, and I think Zeus, that was all timing. I think Zeus was reloading there.
This really is the Counter-Strike suckers now. FHO burning to death in the corner, there's no way SF should have won that 1-on-2. And, I mean, I guess the force buy from Epsilon, it pays off, but this has been a very strange experience already.
That was actually with Na'Vi with a favorable position as far as their defense was concerned as well. They went for a 2-1-2. They had two guys holding on B site, despite a man getting caught out in mid. Like, they couldn't have asked for a better setup to deal with what Epsilon were throwing at them, and they still couldn't hold.
An SF headshots Kirishima. For no good reason.
You know, just making sure he's awake up on that headshot box in the middle. Shoxi charged in the middle alone as well and went down. Guardian is going to get dropped by Kirishima. So a really good return and Edward is down. This is now a big problem. Zeus coming up from behind is going to take down one. Runs in and Kirishima will drop him. This is going to be up to Seized and Starix now to prevent what is happening here. Because this is the last round of the half. They got to stay alive and Seized. They haven't seen him in here. No one's checking the back corner. This could lose the round for Epsilon. But then Seize
it's not good enough.
What?
It's not good enough. He goes for a mad spray, tries to get two of them, and he gets only one. So it's only a one for one there. Starx goes for the same nade with the molly. He's really looking to catch somebody off guard. Doesn't spot the one. He spots the one on the B site, but there's still a man alive behind Big Box, and now he gets spotted out. This should be a round for Epsilon again.
It should be, unless they keep peeking him. They really don't need to. They can just wait until he actually walks in here. Now they can peek him, and they can actually double-team him. Starry's going to take down one. Pistol is out, and GMX goes down. And there's enough time. This was Epsilon just utterly, utterly misplaying that round.
Well, that's like you said, this is the Counter-Strike circus right now. You see, C's making a brilliant decision not to show themselves for so long. Being so cool and collected, and then he kind of just loses it and goes for the mad spray and gets virtually nothing out of it. He gets one kill, sure, but that should have easily been two easy kills and a potential third, right?
Yeah.
And afterwards, you see the constant repeaks from Epsilon, and after Starix actually goes into the bomb site, no one from Epsilon actually hit him once.
Yeah. There was just, a complete screw-up from... I think this whole first half has just been a series... It's been a contest about who can make the most mistakes, basically. And whatever team, well, has made the most, they've lost more rounds, and that's just what it's at right now. Really, really strange first half here on Dust2, and it kind of follows in the same track of what we saw yesterday, although I don't think anyone has quite hit the level of Zeus walking in with a grenade to the bombsite. That was still... That takes the cake for a couple of years at least, but now we're going to be going into the second half here. This game is just a strange and interesting one. Welcome to the show if you're just joining us. This is Na'Vi versus Epsilon in a best-of-one game SLTV Star Series here at Room on Fire. Thank you for joining us. Remember to follow and subscribe and click the links at the bottom of the stream and it'll make us really happy. This pistol round, I guess, could really determine a lot because these teams are looking very shaky at the moment.
It's looking really weird, you're right. I'm not too sure what to think right now. Especially out of a team like Na'Vi where we're so used to seeing everything so dialed in. That this individual play that's really coming out from on the team, it just doesn't seem to fit. It feels really weird. It's not like we're watching Na'Vi right now.
No, but it's like we were watching Na'Vi from yesterday. Definitely a very similar experience. Kirishima peeking a little bit in the middle, but not too much. Just get some information and force back. That's good. They have pretty much given up the B bomb site at this point, so if Na'Vi do end up with a B push, okay. That was an actual backflip that Guardian did from that grenade on Shoxi. Starix here fighting it up with a lot of people. It's going to go down and not the best start, but they can still recover. They're charging in. If they can kill one guy here, it's going to be pretty good for them. Trying to see if they can do it. Shoxi's down. Kirishima in the back is going to be dropped as well. And now Edward is about to make the most incredible fake of his life here. All walking up towards the A bombsite. Seize and Zeus just have to stay alive. Seize fighting it out. It's going to die eventually, but this is still great. The bomb is going to go down, and Zeus is holding the middle, and Epsilon, they're about to have a real awakening here. What just happened?
That fake! They were still waiting around. They took them like 3 seconds to catch on to the fact that the bomb was planted at the other site, and now look at Zeus. He's going to push in from CT with the flank.
Yeah,
oh, this is burning so much time off the clock.
FHO is going to go down, and the one is round. Zeus with the triple, but Edward with a lot, gave him a lot of credit here for what he just did. That was so sick. And Epsilon lose that round in spite of a great double kill early on here, or they got to, you know, kill each. That was, should have probably been the round, I think, for Epsilon.
Yeah, especially because they managed to kill off Guardian, who was the guy who was supposed to set up everything for Navi that round. He was the one who had bought the nades. So he was about to smoke off CT spawn for them to do a pretty standard B split when Shaxx's Hail Mary grenade popped by. So yeah, I definitely thought Epsilon would have had it, especially after they picked up the one Navi player and the B tunnels. After that, I think that definitely should have been what sealed the deal.
Cease is going to be walking right into the middle, seeing if he can pick off anyone. Obviously, there is armor and CSET 75s, all CSET 75s here on the French side, and they are going to be basically sandwiched in this B bomb site. Kiyoshima goes for the peak. Shaxx is going to pick up one, and that's going to be all they get in that bomb site, unfortunately. Just very, very hard to defend when you only have two people there and they're coming in from either angle.
Yeah, but so far we're seeing a lot of the same things from Navi that we saw versus Penta, and Reason for that matter. Which is B-splits. That's the name of the game for Navi right now.
Did I manage to say... I think I managed to say the one is round the other time. That's great. That's, that has to be a thing. Can we keep that? The one is round.
The one is round.
Yeah, that was obviously supposed to be the other way around, but I think my brain, as Navi and Epsilon are making more and more mistakes, my brain is slowly just degenerating, and I actually just can't think any longer.
Well, if it's any comfort, it sounded correct to me.
Alright, that's good.
Yeah, I bought it.
Alright, good enough. Good enough then. We'll see. 9-8 here, 18th round coming up. I'm really curious to see how Epsilon are going to recover from this.
I'm actually more curious to see if Navi are going to continue on with these B-splits, and if they do, how long is it going to take Epsilon to figure it out?
That's a good question. I imagine they're going to start maybe going for more of like a 2-1-2 sort of setup on Epsilon's side, decide to throw that in with the first buy round here. Could be pretty interesting. Shaxx and Kiyoshima are doubled up on the B-site right now, though, looking towards that upper dark. Kiyoshima gets the drop, and Shaxx insta-gives Starks with a sick double kill to start and open up that site.
Yeah, I like the idea, though, for what they had going on, Epsilon. I think it's nice having one guy peek from far away and then one guy close. It's a simple setup, but it's kind of cool.
It's just, it's very clean, and Shaxx, man, I mean, if there was, like, a flash or something, anything at all, that could have been a slaughter, but not happening.
GMX gonna be walking out, and they are actually waiting for him as well. Yeah, Seuss is right here, so GMX is about to go down. Shouldn't be an issue, and it's a flawless round for Na'Vi, so it's a lot of money on their side. And if you remember in the first half, how many rounds in the beginning Epsilon had that they only barely won, bringing it down to, you know, a 1-on-1 or 2-on-2. So Na'Vi have a much better start to the second half than Epsilon ever did. And that could also be a factor. If Epsilon can start picking up rounds here, they're gonna have to win a lot in a row before they can really put pressure on Na'Vi. Flashes out towards Long, and actually Epsilon aren't going to contest it. They're just letting Long go. What do you think about that, man?
I'm actually okay with it, because they've set up Apexio on short already, and they're able to kind of swap it around, so FXO is now holding with the AWP from sight. And I think that's perfectly fine, as long as he is picking it carefully, as he is doing right now, so he's not in danger of getting flashed out and picked off easily.
If he peeks all the way down, Guardian is winning down here, and that's the whole play from Na'Vi right now. There it is. Hook, line, and sinker. FXO, he ate that raw. That was all that Na'Vi wanted from that one. GMX up on short, gonna go down. SF will be dropped, and a great start here. That was very, very carefully executed by Na'Vi.
Look at this by Na'Vi, though. Right now, the prediction on Shaxx's play. They sent Seized forward with only like 4 points of health, though, so that was a little bit odd. I guess it doesn't really matter if he gets the kill, great. If not, they don't really need him for taking over the A site.
And now, Kiyoshima and Shaxx are left, and they really need to hold on to these rifles. I think it's going to be very important for the remainder of this game. Shaxx is down in the middle here. Edward fighting it out with Kiyoshima, and Kiyoshima can't really stay for too long, because then Su shows up. And that's it. So the whole point of this plane, it's not the first time we've seen it either. You take up along, you leave one guy in pit with an AWP, and then you fall back. The rest of the team just falls back to the middle and waits. And eventually, there's a really high chance whatever counter-terrorist had fallen back from along initially, they're going to be impatient, and they're going to want to see if there's any terrorists down here looking. And there was, but it's a guy with an AWP, so I think you even said it before it happened, Vendetta. The whole point of that is he's got to be peeking carefully, and he was right up until the end when he wasn't.
Yeah, and I think that kind of blew everything open. It was the gateway, really, for Na'Vi to take that A site.
Look at this setup here from Epsilon. Three guys stacked up on B with a force buy out of them. Three rifles waiting. Do they make it? And Na'Vi, they're throwing a fake right now. They're making it look like it's going to be a B play. Two members from Epsilon are pushing into upper dark, but they're about to get confirmation. Nobody is here. The party's going to be on A, guys. And GMX gets confirmation, sees them on cat, but it's too late.
Yeah, he needs to wait a lot here, but the big problem is, as well, there's one guy in the middle, that's Starix. If he catches anyone with them rotating, the round ends there and then, pretty much. Good shots coming out from GM, actually doing a lot of damage here. Starix is going to walk right in, take down one, and I think this is it. That now, they have to worry about Starix before they can even worry about the bomb site, so that's the big deal. Even if Starix goes down here, he's bought a lot of time. The bomb are actually not being planted yet here. Sush really delaying that plant.
Yeah, they just want to get full control over the site. Yeah, and again, I think this is more down to Epsilon playing their CT side really awkwardly than anything else. They're kind of giving it away. GMX could have easily avoided being picked off by Guardian in that situation. Obviously, he wants to buy as much time as possible by just hanging around and not showing himself, and he had already done a pretty okay job at that, but he could have easily survived for at least 10 to 5, or 5 to 10 seconds more, and I think that would have done a lot for Epsilon.
Probably would have, but at this point, they're about to be 4 rounds behind. Na'Vi are on the more favorite side, and they have a lot of money to work with, and they have a lot of rounds they can throw away before it really starts to get critical. Kiyoshima just needs to hide and save the AK. He will do a good job of that. We'll see. I mean, this game is not over yet, but I'm really, really starting to doubt if Epsilon can do this.
Well, the force by FAMAS is not going to help things either. We're not seeing FXCO get that AWP that he loves so much. I mean, he can do damage with the rifle, but him with the AWP could really be something that Epsilon can rely on to put a stop to the Na'Vi pushes. Epsilon changing up the way that they're holding this time, though, with two guys up close on short. They're really expecting Na'Vi to be perhaps going for the fake again. I mean, it's interesting to see Epsilon at least not sticking to one way to hold on CT. They're really going through the motions and trying out a bunch of different tactics here.
Yeah, that is good, I think. That's definitely worth it for them to do right now, because they need to catch Na'Vi off guard somehow. And actually, the fact that they're pushing a little bit aggressively up on short here is kind of a cool idea. If they can pick somebody off down here in the middle, that'll be a really big start for them. But I think the other big problem right now is that they don't have an AWP on FFHO.
Their setup is kind of reminiscent of something you would do with an AWP, which is kind of what we saw in the previous round, where Na'Vi did something similar, although Edward is with Guardian at long right now. So I think that's kind of what Na'Vi are doing. They're playing the waiting game and hoping that FXO is going to peek out.
Oh, smoke disappears, and GMX just walking back and forth, or making sure he doesn't get flashed too much, actually going to get the kill, but now Starix with the return. Up on short, it's going to be SF going down as well, and it all just crumbles in a matter of seconds as Na'Vi destroys the Epsilon defense, and Kiyoshima down in the middle here is going to be going down as well. So it was a try, but it was nowhere near good enough here for the Frenchman, and now we're looking at a 13-8 scoreline.
It's just looking dominant right now. Again, coming down to the shots, and again, Epsilon Force.
They're in that.
Oh, shoddy situation. Actually had enough for an AWP though.
Yeah.
Oh, and he's gonna be taking down Guardian. So, okay, that might be the one save. I mean, I think they need FXO and Shoxi to go utterly mad here. Shoxi's actually at 14 kills, so it's not like he's really doing badly. But they need those two to step up and be all that they can be.
That inspirational talk right there.
Motivational speech.
Yeah. They're raring to go now, Anders.
Well, I mean, they need something, because with the amount of incredible mistakes they've been making in the first half, I think, I don't know, it's going to take something special. We do need, like, a, you know, some sort of boost coming in here from Epsilon.
Well, let's see if they can get on the board. That's the thing here, because let's keep in mind, Na'Vi have had a perfect half so far. And they're looking like they're going to be in a pretty decent spot to pick up another one here. Shoxi at the back of Plateau, but Guardian is here to take a shot at him. Shoxi just peeking, and they catch the man off guard. Kiyoshima with a nade out in hand. Shoxi's gone. And just like that, Na'Vi with the perfect insertion on the B site.
Yeah, and Ben, do you want to take me through what they were thinking? Why was nobody covering hallways?
That beats me. That's all I can say. I don't really have an answer for that. A lot of the decision making from Epsilon on the CT side has really confused me.
Yeah, I'm actually just blown away by the lack of even just like common sense that goes into that defense.
What do you mean?
So, okay. The idea of having Kiyoshima looking down the middle and having Shoxi in the back flashing over the wall is a really good one. It's a really good idea. But they can execute that flash even if Shoxi... Like, they can just have Kiyoshima peeking, and when Kiyoshima says, oh, there are guys in the middle, then Shoxi can just, you know, go away from holding the hallways, and he can throw the flash out. But they just decided, we're gonna bank everything on the idea that they are gonna be going middle before they go upper. That's what they did that round. The exact same defense could have happened if Shoxi had been peeking upper. Down to the very last detail, the exact same detail could have happened. They just didn't.
I think that's really because Navi's previous B splits have been through the middle. Like, the initiation has happened through middle first, the previous rounds. But I think it's still really silly from Epsilon to really bank everything on it.
The problem is that it's not like they can do one or the other. This time they could have had both. They could have had their cake and eaten it. The flash out the middle is a really good idea. I like the detail. And I wish it would have worked, because it would have been a really fun idea having Kiyoshima peek like that. But they could have done it even with Shoxi, you know, still covering one entrance to the bombsite.
Yeah, they absolutely could. And again, Epsilon are making a lot of weird decisions on the CT side.
Goddamn, Guardian is good.
He is fast. There's a triple kill coming out here, and Na'Vi looking... I guess the second half here, they're looking a lot better. In the first half, I guess they were making just about as many mistakes as Epsilon were. But they've managed to switch it up, whereas the Frenchmen definitely have not. Now it's 15-8, and we're moving into that 24th round.
Yeah. And GMX has crashed.
Oh, that's not a good time to do that.
Yeah, it really isn't, but to be honest, I really think the game is over by now, and it has been for a while with the way Epsilon are playing.
Yeah, I agree, unfortunately. It's just that it looks like even, I don't know, it's really hard to watch, actually. It's just kind of disappointing, I would say.
It is, especially because even with all the mistakes they made on their T side, they managed to get rounds, quite a few of them, and... Obviously, Na'Vi made a couple of mistakes as well, but it was fairly even, and the first half ended fairly evenly as well. So I was kind of hoping for something similar in the second half, but it seems like Na'Vi has cleaned up their act, and Epsilon are just running away with the prize for most mistakes in the game.
Oh, it seems like right now, on top of everything else, Na'Vi, I guess Zeus really is in his element, because they don't seem to be making the wrong calls at any point in time, and they seem to be getting a step ahead of Epsilon. Because notice, you know, Van, you made that point of how they're both fully committing to mid, right? Because all these other rounds, Na'Vi have come through mid doors to rush up B slope towards that B site. And again, Na'Vi get like that extra step ahead of Epsilon by changing it up this time and going everybody through upper dark. Epsilon expecting the B push to be coming from B slope, they get caught off guard. But it's been like cat pushes, long pushes. Na'Vi just seem to be a step ahead of Epsilon at every turn here. Yeah, but GMX is back in the game, so we have to see. Are they able to save their honor here and get at least one round in this half?
I don't think so.
No, I'm not convinced either that it's going to happen. Man, it's... Okay, so let me put out a theory here, because now we've seen Na'Vi had some really weird couple of days here. We've seen Epsilon have, you know, weird game right here, and I'm wondering if it's the weight of, you know, all the practice they're putting in, that some of these teams are simply so focused on, you know, whatever refinements they're doing before the big tournaments, that, you know, some of the basic stuff that goes into some of these rounds just go right out the window.
Well, there's something to keep in mind. There's a lot of official matches that are happening right now for both of these teams. I mean, hell, both of these teams were involved in the qualifier throughout all this weekend. So we're talking like at least 18 hours of CS in 2 days for both of these teams. That's a lot of CS. And then you come into tonight, officials. You're having matches every single night. Doesn't leave you much time for refinement. You just have to kind of hit the ground running and go.
That is true. And events like G3 and Gamescom are coming up, so...
Yeah, and... we know how much practice matters to this team. I mean, they're not spending their time focusing on this best of one game against NaVi. They're spending their time worrying about the upcoming tournament.
A best of three, 2 weeks from
exactly.
now.
Exactly. So that could be a factor as well. It's certainly been a very, very strange past couple of days, but we'll see if we can get something more out of it. Guys, our next game coming up is going to be between Titan and Epsilon.